Now to the IRS scandal in Washington, outrage continuing to grow over it, along with the demand for answers. Nine on Your Side reporter Natasha Williams is live with what your lawmakers are saying about all of this. Natasha?
Well, Clyde, Sherrod Brown called the IRS situation a double scandal with plenty of blame to go around. Today, Nine on Your Side spoke with the Ohio Senator and Speaker of the House, John Boehner, as well. Now, both lawmakers are waiting for the results of the FBI investigations, but also are very clear about their feelings about the wrongdoing, the Cincinnati IRS office, the things that happened there anyway. Now, Senator Sherrod Brown says, although it appears the IRS workers did overstep their authority, they apparently missed some things as well.
The IRS clearly erred in picking out Tea Party groups or whatever. They shouldn't do that. They should apply the law evenly, but they shouldn't let these tens of millions of dollars be spent by groups that say they're charitable groups when in fact they're political organizations and special interest groups. The law is pretty clear, and they should be enforcing it.
Well, I want to see the facts. I want to know how this happened, who was responsible for it. It's clear that there is law. Section 7214 of the Title 26 of the U.S. Code states very clearly, any officer or employee of the United States acting in connection with any revenue law of the United States who is guilty of extortion or willful oppression under the color of law shall be dismissed from office and, if convicted, be fined up to $10,000 and spend 5 years in jail.
The WCPO digital team is also digging deep into the story for you right now. WCPO.com will have background information on the new acting commissioner of the IRS and copies of documents sent to conservative groups. Natasha Williams, 9 on Your Side.
Okay, Natasha, thanks.